Hello, I'm Anna Christiansen, speaking to you from Oslo, Norway. And I'm greeting you in the new year 2021. Oh, we are in such a need of hearing what the Spirit of God is speaking into our lives. It's really time to seek the Lord and to hear what the Spirit is saying and to be empowered by the Spirit of God. Oh, we need prayer, don't we? And the wonderful thing is that we can pray everywhere and we can pray all the time. We can always seek God. But, you know, I want to focus today on our homes. You know, Billy Graham, he said many wonderful things. And one of them is this: the true test of a Christian is the way he or she lives in their home. How do we live at home? How am I at home? And you know, the place, maybe the secret place, that's such a blessed place where we can be with God and seek God and hear what He's speaking into our lives and into our time. So how do I live at home? Really, let's consecrate the prayer altars in our homes this year. And as we approach this year, we are in the beginning, let us establish prayer in our homes and really say, God, you know, the first disciples, they said, God, teach us to pray. They didn't say, God, teach us to raise the dead, or God, teach us to cleanse the lepers. But they said, God, teach us to pray, because they knew that's the source. That's the source. Jesus, we need you to teach us to pray. And that's our need today as well as believers. You know, in the beginning, the believers, they were called Christians because they reminded people of Christ. And I think this time is time for us to say, as Christians, because today we are called Christians all over the world, it's time for us to say again, I want to be called a disciple. I want to be a disciple. And disciples, they seek God, they pray, and we get the wisdom that we need for the day. Dear friends, let us pray together and thank God that we have a message to bring in this time. Our message, the most important message we can give to our world these days and this year, is John 3:16-17. I want to read it to us from the scripture. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. Friends, let's pray that this message will be spread all over our world, through our lives as disciples. Let us seek God in prayer together. Amen. Father, I thank You that You are with us as we enter into 2021. All over the world, Father God, You are raising up disciples, believers. We seek Your face, God, and we pray that You will enable us and empower us where we are to live from our homes into the world with this message. So have You loved the world that You gave Jesus. Let us give Jesus as we go about this year, Father. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.